up bright and early this morning?
Not as early as you. What were you doing?
I swam a mile in the ocean, ran 5 miles along the beach, went for a little kayak paddle.
Wow, that's a pretty serious workout.
No, that's a warm-up. Now a workout.
Oh. I used to do 100 sit-ups every morning. I guess I won't be doing that for a while.
Well, I'm sure you can afford to relax a little before you start turning to flab.
I also used to work out at the Quartermain gym sometimes. I'm just not as devoted as you.
Well, I learned a long time ago to test the limits. It takes focus.
To win, you mean?
Well, to win, it takes 3 things, actually. Discipline, focus, and faith.
Yeah, faith in yourself.
Certainly. But then it helps to have something to fall back onto. I always use this.
What's this?
It's an Aboriginal charm. When I was a boy, before we struck it lucky in Alaska, we lived in a small town in Western Australia. My best friend was an Aboriginal boy named Thomas. He was a couple of years older than me, but we were inseparable. You must have had a friend like that growing up.
No. Go on.
Well, when Aboriginal boys come of age, they're required to go on something called a walkabout, where they spend days and days alone in the outback to test their manhood and spiritual strength. Anyway, when it came time for Thomas to go, I moped around the whole time. Now, I couldn't accept that he'd do something so important and dangerous by himself without me. But before he left, he gave me this. He made it himself. I guess he figured that he might never see me again. But he came back without a scratch.
Wow, you must have been so relieved.
Yeah, I was. Also intensely jealous. So I decided to test my own strength as a man.
Wait a minute. How old were you?
10.
Oh, and don't even tell me that you went out there.
I struck out on my own walkabout, yeah. Not knowing what I'd have to endure.
Why would you do something like that?
To prove that I could. If I hadn't, I might still be searching.
Was it awful?
Well, the trek was okay, but my parents almost killed me when the search party finally found me. Somehow, I always thought that this thing gave me what I needed to survive. Why don't you hang on to it while I work out?
You gonna trust me with something this important?
Hey, I already lead a charmed life, in case you hadn't noticed.
Yeah, I'd like some of that.
Well, that's the plan.
I spoke to my father earlier. He says hello. You know, it still amazes me that he's part of my life again.
I'm glad it worked out for you, Lily.
Yeah, but it wouldn't have if I hadn't given him a second chance. And I did. Thanks to you. Do you have any special plans for tonight?
Yeah. I plan on spending tonight with my beautiful wife.
Would you still want to if she tried to make dinner?
Make dinner as in cook?
Chicken.
Oh, are you calling me that, or are you planning to make one?
You are so silly if the shoe fits.
Did you ever see that old Chaplin movie where, like, he's at a dinner table eating, and there's a big shoe on his plate?
Oh, so that's what you expect from me?
Hey, Lily. I don't expect anything from you.
Well, I do. And I expect myself to do wifely things.
You do the most important wifely things.
Besides that.
No, what I'm talking about is you're very supportive, right? Mm-hmm. You're a great listener. You're good. Besides that.
Seriously.
All right.
I want to be able to throw dinner parties and entertain for you.
Your cooking is pretty entertaining.
Honey?
What?
How am I supposed to improve if I don't practice? Can you take it if I make the attempt?
I can take anything you dish out.
Well, then I promise you won't be sorry.
You're very quiet today.
I have a lot on my mind. Have you ever come close to dying?
Brenda, I brought you here so you wouldn't dwell on that.
I know. I just can't stop thinking about my accident. It was so weird. One second I was standing out in front of Luke's laughing. The next second, that car just came out of nowhere. I remember how I felt. You know, like I was really gonna die.
Yeah, but you did.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know. I guess somebody up there likes you.
Oh. Think so?
Yeah.
You really think it's that simple?
Hey, I firmly believe we have more than one life. The way I see it is, you've been given another chance. My advice to you is, don't blow it.
You're so cool. You really treat me like a princess.
As it should be.
Let's see, you feed me, you clothe me. You're doing some serious work on my self-esteem.
Are you complaining?
No, not at all. I'm just wondering why.
Because I can. Because you deserve it.
You don't want anything in return?
No. Well, not yet anyway.
Perfect. What a shame.
Hello?
Mike, I am so sorry to bother you, but I have a crisis on my hands.
Lily, what's wrong?
Well, you know how I don't know how to cook, and I really want to learn, so I planned dinner for Sonny, and I promised him a gourmet meal.
Well, that was ambitious.
Yeah, too much so, I guess. I swear I cannot be in the kitchen alone without creating a disaster.
What happened?
I burnt it to a crisp. I'm sorry, Mike. I had no one else to call.
All right. Just hold on, honey. I'm on my way. The last time I messed around in Sonny's kitchen, he was not happy.
Oh, yes. The suckling pig. Mm. Well, Stone was happy, and that was the point.
Yeah, well, we managed to get through it. We almost committed mayhem in the process.
You're safe. Sonny won't be home for a while.
Oh. Here,
Bill. Oh, Mike, what's that?
This is a tri-tip roast of beef. One of the most succulent cuts. Very, very difficult to come by. Restaurants snap them up like that. My butcher owed me. You know how to peel potatoes?
Under supervision.
Okay. Good. Now, that's, that's not going to hurt your wrist, is it?
Oh, no, I didn't hurt it that badly.
Oh, well, that's a good thing. So, have they come up with any more leads about the driver yet?
I don't think so. There was no back license plate, and car was ordinary.
Yeah, well, I can't believe that Sonny wouldn't have started some kind of search for the guy that hit his wife.
Well, I'd just as soon forget it. You know, accidents happen. Actually, I wish I would have been a little more hurt. Then maybe I would have an excuse for ruining dinner.
You know, I honestly don't think that Sonny really cares if you can't cook.
Well, I care. He is
He is such a wonderful husband, and he's always trying to do the right thing. He is going to be an amazing father.
Yeah, well, I'm afraid he didn't have much of a role model in that department.
Early on, maybe. But I know for myself, it's never too late.
Yeah, well, I'm sure that he's given you more than an earful when it comes to growing up with the dad that never was and that animal of a stepfather.
Bits and pieces. But I also know that it makes him unhappy, so I don't push. Anyway, today is what counts in all relationships. Did you say these go around the roast?
Yeah, but we have to parboil them first, and then we put them in at the end.
Parboil.
Don't worry, it's a technical term. Okay. Oof. Shall we?
Absolutely.
Would you do the honors, please?
Of course.
Thank you. So, what happened to your first attempt?
Sonny was right. I am hopeless in the kitchen.
Well, I don't know. That looks like a pretty superficial burn. In fact, I'm inclined to say that looks like a case of arson. What's going on, Lily?
Okay. If I would have called you over for dinner, how would you have reacted? Exactly. So I thought I'd cook something up. Busted. Mike's over here on a crisis call.
You had a crisis and you called Mike?
Yes, I had a culinary disaster, so I called an expert. I couldn't very well have called you. Mm. Gee, I just remembered I need to make a call. Excuse me.
What disaster?
This is it. And, this is the fix.
Tri-tip, huh? What'd you do, hold up a butcher shop?
No, I called in a marker.
Same thing. Looks a little dry to me.
Yeah, well, we were planning a demi-glaze.
Yeah? How come I don't smell any sherry?
Well, because I am going to, as is classically done, add it at the end.
All the classical chefs are dead. Anybody worth the kosher salt today knows you add the wine with the roast, which has the effect of glazing as it goes and deepening the flavor.
You're going to get an overstatement.
Not a problem I usually have.
Fine. Hey, it's your kitchen.
Yeah, it is my kitchen. And what are you doing in it?
I was simply answering the call of a damsel in distress who happens to be my daughter-in-law who's trying to make her husband happy.
She already does.
Yeah, well, you don't have to convince me. Maybe she could use a little. Look, please, don't get on her case about this. I mean, she meant well.
Whoa, wait. What are you trying to give me advice on how to treat a woman?
No, that would be very, very foolish of me. She's a sweet lady, Sonny.
Yeah, she is.
And I'm glad that she wasn't hurt worse and not upset even more. She seems to be taking this incident with a car in stride.
Yeah, she's very lucky.
Luckier than Brenda.
Well, you know, Brenda came out of it okay.
Yeah, well, I guess she did. She's well enough to go flying off with some stinking rich Australian.
Yeah, is that what she did?
Yeah. Yeah, rumor has it. Nobody seems to know where. Do you peel these?
Never
You?
Absolutely not. You know, nobody seems to know where that car came from yet.
Yeah, accidents do happen.
Yeah. Well, that's what Lily said, and if she's thinking anything else, she certainly isn't saying so.
Mike, why would she?
Early training. Look, I really don't know much about how these things are done, but I can't help
you. Wait, Mike, enough. It's not your worry.
Not directly. No, mm-hmm. No. But it is yours problem, and I'm sure you're handling it very well.
Yeah.
All right. Just to reassure you, I will not mention my theory to anyone, not even Luke.
Oh, great. You're finally minding your own business.
It's family business.
So how's everything in here?
Oh, hey. Could be worse.
Well, you had a good start on things.
Will you be joining us for dinner?
No. Maybe another time.
Okay. I'm sorry, but I had to just this once. I suppose it has to do with my own father.
How do you mean?
Well, I never would have thought it possible, but my father and I have managed to bridge the space between us, a space that was filled with the past, anger and recriminations. And we're on the other side of that now. Our relationship goes on from here.
How does that put Mike in my kitchen, Lily?
I wanted to give you two a chance for a new start.
Lily, you know, I appreciate what you're trying to do. I really do. But no matter how many times Mike and I are in the same room, we're not going to end up going fishing or to the ball games together.
I know that, Sonny. You can't rewrite the past. I tried that with Miguel and I failed.
Then why do you think you can
because
do it now?
Because what you can do is accept the past and move on.
I'm that's exactly what I'm doing.
No, you're trying to wipe it out by keeping Mike out of it.
No, nobody asked Mike back here, and he shows up and he hasn't left.
Exactly. Doesn't that tell you he's changed? You said that in the past he always left.
Why is this so important to you now? Why are you into this all of a sudden?
Because I love you. And I see your kindness and your loyalty and your generosity to the people you care about.
The people I care about?
But, Sonny, I also see a terribly lonely man.
Isn't it great?
Crazy.
Yeah, like a fox.
I'm serious.
I've had so much fun with you. I've had such a good time. I don't know why I'd want to leave.
Little unfinished business to take care of, maybe. Something to prove?
I don't know. But I know it's what I need to do.
That's what you think you need. and you'll go after it, and you'll probably get it. What you don't realize is that once it's yours, it won't make you happy.
Sounds like you've been there.
Let's just say that it comes under the heading, do as I say, not as I do.
Is in Port Charles. That's where my friends are, you know? I don't know. Maybe they don't even know I'm gone. What do you think?
No, I think they're missing you.
Yeah.
You leave a black hole in your wake, Brenda. Day. That promise I told you I'd have trouble keeping, I can promise you I won't be able to keep it. Guess we're ready to roll.
Yeah.
That's how it's been all your life. You've had losses recently, Sonny. And I'm not just talking about a love affair. I'm talking about Stone, who was like your brother. You're not partners with Luke anymore.
Luke's still a friend. Listen, Mrs. Corinthos, I have a great life. Because you're in it. That's enough. You don't need to worry about me. I'm asking you to stop.
I'll try. Oh, my God. The smell. Oh, no, it's the roast. No. I cannot do anything right today.
You are the rightest thing around. Anybody who slaves all day in the kitchen for me deserves a medal.
Yeah. What did it get me?
It got you a night out in the town, wherever you want.
Okay. Only because I know I don't have a choice. But I'm warning you. I'm not giving up.